Tonight we share a one-of-a-kind look at the effects of tolls on the downtown and midtown tunnels. Our investigation reveals hundreds of millions of dollars generated by toll fees over the past 2 years.
Plus, millions of drivers may have passed through the tunnels without paying. Investigative reporter Evan Watson explains how he uncovered this information and what it means for you.
Driving the downtown and midtown tunnels between Norfolk and Portsmouth, there's one inevitability.
Tolls are going to be unavoidable.
Anywhere from $1.85 to nearly $13, depending on your car, tag, and time of day. In the last 2 years, vehicles passed through the tunnels nearly 70 million times.
Elizabeth River Crossings operates the tunnels on behalf of private companies. Historically, ERC has opted not to release information about revenues or how many tolls are actually being paid. To find that information, we took another route.
The downtown and midtown tunnels are managed under an agreement with the Commonwealth of Virginia. We filed public records requests with VDOT, receiving daily tunnel reports for the last 2 years. A detailed data analysis shows ERC generated about $202 million in toll revenue over a 2-year stretch between September 2019 and September 2021. That accounts for easy pass and pay-by-plate rides, peak and off-peak pricing, and passenger and heavy vehicles. It doesn't include late fees or additional charges.
The vast majority of people pay the toll, and we expect everyone to pay the toll.
ERC CEO David Sullivan says the company doesn't write off any unpaid tolls as uncollectible. It still pursues them. But ERC declined to share any information about the percentage of tolls that were successfully paid. However, in other states, that information is public record. The Pennsylvania Turnpike Commission, for example, reports 6.6% of all transactions were not paid last year after the collections and invoice process. Applying that to the downtown and midtown tunnels, that would estimate no toll revenue for about 4.6 million rides over the last 2 years. That represents about $13.3 million in free trips.
And if some people aren't putting in their fair share, then it sort of detracts and discourages others.
Sullivan says the tunnels are very different from the Pennsylvania Turnpike. They're much smaller and more used by commuters than out-of-state drivers. It's easier to collect tolls from Virginia drivers, as ERC can put holds on vehicle registrations until toll fees are paid. However, Sullivan wouldn't clarify how many tolls go unpaid.
At this point, we're not going to share what our leakage number is. I would say it's a small percentage.
ERC has the right to raise toll prices up to 3.5% annually until 2070 per the contract with the state. A 2019 Life in Hampton Roads survey from Old Dominion University found nearly half of all respondents said they avoided visiting neighboring cities due to tolls.
We've seen through the research that some people take very drastic behaviors, especially if it's a commute, a daily commute.
There's no cap on revenues for the private companies managing the downtown and midtown tunnels. But state leaders and toll researchers tell 13 News Now there would likely be less pressure for ERC to increase toll prices once it pays off close to $1 billion in debt. If Hampton Roads drivers owe millions of dollars in unpaid tolls each year, that could delay price relief for everyone else. When asked about this, Sullivan said long-term maintenance projects will be expensive, and it's difficult to project what will happen decades down the line.
Our response is we expect everybody to pay the toll, and we work hard to make sure that happens.
In Portsmouth, Evan Watson reporting for 13 News Now.
Well, last year, the new owners of the tunnels agreed to extend a toll relief program offered to Norfolk and Portsmouth drivers. It will now last until 2037.
ERC contributes $500,000 to this program each year.